Tonight, inside a meeting of fake Trump electors, a newly scrutinized podcast revealing how Trump supporters in Wisconsin tried, but ultimately failed, to overturn the election results in their state. It's one of seven states where Team Trump, led by Rudy Giuliani, tried to pull this off. Kyung Lah is out front with tonight's Inside Look.
In just moments, six more states are convening. Minnesota, New Mexico, Wisconsin.
December 14th, 2020. In Madison, Wisconsin.
To Joseph R. Biden Jr.
The state electors officially cast their votes for Biden. But elsewhere in Wisconsin's capital, another meeting of fake electors was happening at the same time.
It's all super secret for security reasons, so we met in a secret location. We waited for almost an hour before they took us to the state capitol.
That's Bill Feehan, one of 10 Republican electors who signed this certificate of the 2020 electors. They declared Donald Trump won Wisconsin's electoral votes. The problem, Trump lost. But that didn't stop these wannabe Republican electors. Feehan, in a deleted Facebook post, snapped a photo of himself and others in the meeting as they met secretly with guards to protect them. Feehan also detailed this a year ago in his newly scrutinized podcast.
There was security, armed security to protect us, and other officials from the Republican Party of Wisconsin were there. We had a meeting room reserved, and that's where we met to cast our ballots in the Electoral College. Each of us cast a ballot for President of the United States, and we cast a ballot for Vice President of the United States. In the event that something would transpire legally here where the outcome in Wisconsin would be reversed, then our ballots would be sent to Washington, D.C., and those would be the ballots that get counted.
I thought they were all going on a magical mystery tour from listening to them. I mean, the reality of the legal situation is that what they were about to do would have absolutely no legal force at all.
Longtime Republican election lawyer Ben Ginsburg says despite that and repeated court losses across the country, fake electors from multiple swing states, from Wisconsin to Arizona,
with the undersigned being the duly elected and qualified electors,
met to sign phony documents declaring Trump the winner, submitting them to Congress to try and stop the electoral vote count. The Justice Department is investigating, and the January 6th Select Committee has subpoenaed 14 Republicans from seven states who served as fake electors as part of the Trump campaign's attempts to subvert the Electoral College.
Joseph R. Biden Jr. of the state of Delaware has received 306 votes.
That would ultimately fail. But the frenzy that drove the fake electors to try and stop the electoral vote count is a part of the puzzle that led to the Capitol insurrection, says Ginsburg.
It certainly was an attempt to stop the peaceful transfer of power and to stop the count of the Electoral College. And had that succeeded, it certainly would have undermined democracy.
We did reach out to Bill Feehan by phone and email. We did not hear back from him. We did hear from the Wisconsin Republican Party. A spokeswoman says that even though Feehan described it on his podcast as a secretive meeting, she wrote to us, quote, "It wasn't secretive despite the efforts to rewrite history for clicks." And she points out, Aaron, that the party did put out a statement on the day that this meeting happened, that it had happened, but they published it after the meeting was all over. Aaron?
Kyung, thank you very much.